Deacon.
Oh, yeah.
We just thank God today, and it's a blessing to be here and stand before you. And we just want to say we appreciate you. I'm in Texas now. That's a deep, you know, Davenport. Pastor Davenport, we just appreciate you for honoring my sister, Pastor Pat Wright. We really appreciate that. He didn't have to do it, and but God put it on his heart to do it. And I just thank him. And also, there's a book back there in case you want to leave some, write a love note to her. There's a tablet back there. You can do that after service. And but she had to leave. She really wasn't feeling well. She had some health issues. For one of the reasons she retired. And so sometimes they raise their ugly head at her and see how to roll. But we thank God that she was able to get here for that short time. But we just want to do what God has given us to do the best we can do and get out your way. Because, well, you know, the Seahawks already playing. Last I heard, they was up 20-0, so they ain't gonna lie. So you can turn off your phone and all that stuff. If you want to do anything, you're going to take a little nap now and I'm up. Pastor, sit down, rest. You can go and take a little nap and all that good stuff. But we just give praise to God today. Ain't nobody like God.
Ain't nobody.
I looked out the window, and what did I see? A world full of mess just staring at me. People going here and people going there, written on their faces, though, words I don't care. Why is it that people have been so mean? What's it all about? Is it some mad dream? In the beginning, God said it was good. Somehow the world's not doing that it should. The world keeps spinning, but the beauty is promoted. The powers of man have become so devoted. People keep doing things that make you wonder why.
What a wonderful world. What a a wonderful word. And our key word today is wonderful, meaning extraordinarily good or great, fantastic, magnificent, marvelous. What a wonderful word. My, my, my. What a world we live in today. You have drugs stealing lives. You have crime escalating without abatement or interruption. You have wars and rumors of war. Weather is all wacko with one terrible storm, one after another. Tragedies of every kind covers the globe. Folk killing each other over nothing. Folk stealing to keep from getting the 9 to 5. Folk fussing and cussing. Church folk and church leaders causing confusion in the camaraderie of the membership. Forests are being chopped to smithereens. The rest are burning out of control. Land is being polluted to the point of uselessness. Waterways are so full of deadly chemicals and industrial runoff that it is a danger to go near them. Drinking water is becoming undrinkable. The air we breathe that we need for life itself is so poison it makes people sick. Marriages are falling like a row of dominoes. Kids are so out of control that they have no respect for anyone, not even the preacher, not to mention their own parents. World leaders refuse to care for the people of their own country, even in the United States. They hoard all the wealth for themselves. Political corruption is out of control, caused by all parties. From the White House to your house, down to the church house, mess be running wild. Whether it be Trump or them other boys before him, they all brought mess to the world and did nothing to brighten the world, to ease the troubles of the world, and a whole bunch of you ain't doing nothing either to make the world better. Folk walking around all nervous and afraid. Folk all anxious and distrustful. Folk all depressed and disillusioned. Folk backbiting. Folk starting false rumors. Folk disrespecting. Hope grows dim. Smiles erode. Bad attitudes abound. Peace is just a distant dream. Love has grown cold. The world is just one big junk pile of out of control ego. The world is just one big ball of confusion. The world is crying and no one seems to care. Then you got life stuff coming at you all day long. You got money issues, children issues, health issues, church issues, job issues, housing issues, people issues, stuff coming at you like bird poo dropping on your windshield, making you scream, what the? You know you said it and you finished it. The world is spinning, but you just don't seem to be winning. Chaos is everywhere. My, oh my. What happened? Well, God proclaimed his creation was all good. Then he instructed man to oversee the creation.
Yes,
well, man oversaw it all right. After man introduced sin to the world, that was a big introduction right there. The world now finds itself being mutilated. Abused and mismanaged by whom else? Man. You know what? When I say man, I'm throwing women to that both of them. You got that, right? You got that. Don't get me looking down a one-way street. This two-way street thing right here. Sin working in man has steadily moved
of righteous leadership. The world.
My.
So I suppose you might be asking by now, some of y'all anyhow, hey preacher,
hey,
you are painting such a bleak and worrisome picture of gloom here. Where is the wonderful word you were supposed to be talking about? You said it was in your topic. What about the world, right?
Well,
sir.
I'm not finished yet.
Though I know you wish I were. Raise your hand and wish I was there right now.
Keep going.
I see in your brain you raise it. I know what you mean. But I don't care. We're going on in Jesus' name. Our scripture lesson tells us that Jesus and the disciples were relaxing and having a conversation after the Last Supper.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus is still instructing them and giving them words of wisdom that can only come from God.
Yes.
That's some good stuff when it comes from God.
Amen.
What kind of words are you giving to those around you?
Okay.
Are they words from God? Are they words from you? Try to destroy and just mess things up. Basically, Jesus was telling them goodbye for them.
Okay.
With all the events that were about to occur regarding his cross experience and his departure back to heaven, this would be the only real time they had left for a conversation and live. Jesus revealed many things to them and answered their questions. He then speaks the words of our scripture lesson. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. When Jesus says, peace I leave with you, indicates to the disciples that he was leaving for a little while. But Jesus was not leaving them empty-handed. How many times you have left somebody empty-handed? Knowing that they had a need. Jesus was leaving them peace. But not just any kind of peace.
Yes.
But Jesus said, my peace.
Hallelujah.
I give to you. The gift of peace Jesus was leaving with the disciples was a personal gift from himself to them. And Jesus told them that his gift of peace was not as the world would give. Because you see, worldly peace is wimpy and fragile. But Jesus' personal gift of peace is special, unique,
yes,
and perfect.
Yes.
It is always strong, spiritual, and everlasting. Jesus' gift of peace is so potent that he tells the disciples to not let your heart be troubled.
Yes.
Neither let it be afraid. How many times have you told somebody, don't be afraid, then they get beat up? Why are you running away? Jesus' gift of peace will enable the disciples not to be troubled or afraid of the world, the condition of the world, or even the craziness that people would perpetuate in the world. The gift of peace that Jesus gives removes fear and dread from the heart. For Jesus is in control of all circumstances.
Yes, Lord.
With Jesus' peace within them, they didn't have to be consumed with the worldly concerns around them. How many times you wake up in the morning and say, oh Lord, here we go again. You're going to help me with that. Though the world may be chaotic around them, and they would have to live within the chaos, you living within
Sunday morning. These other people ain't saying that, bro.
to him for help. He rescues them from their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted. He rescues those whose spirits are crushed. The righteous person faces many troubles, but the Lord comes to the rescue every time. Every time. Know this forever. Can't nobody do you like Jesus. Can't nobody befriend you like Jesus. Can't nobody protect you like Jesus. Can't nobody refresh you like Jesus. Can't nobody love you like Jesus. Can't nobody save you like Jesus. Can't nobody be Jesus except Jesus.
Hey, what's all this preparation because, hand of God.
Yes. Peace was fully awake there. Yes. Walking around and talking to folks.
Hey,
peace was alive and well. And people everywhere could now receive God's peace. When you receive Jesus in your life as your Savior, then you can have great peace, for Jesus is peace. Let Jesus' peace open your eyes and heart to the wonderful world that God has created. forgiven by Jesus Christ through his love. You need to get undone. What a wonderful world.
Oh, yes.
As my boy on the back of the bulletin says. Thank you for listening.
Amen.